Okay, everyone. Okay, I'm going to show you the new doors that I made, upgraded doors. I wasn't happy with the original doors, which basically you stuck your plastic on the back straight, and I didn't like the look of it. So what I did, I made new molds, and actually made indentation on the back of the doors, as you can see, on top and bottom, and I put a small notch on the top section. This will actually hold the door flush with the body. And you'll notice in all the photographs that there's a slight gap between the top roof and the door rim. So what you do now is you take your door, once you've prepared your little hole, and with a little notch, you just put the notch underneath, fit the thing in and fit it in, and now you see it sits flush on both sides. If you see a small gap, you can use filler. Just put filler on the door, let it dry, and then just sand it down so it's smooth. Okay, so that's a lot better look to me. In the kit you'll get a plastic sheet and a template. Okay, this template, like I explained before, is for the bottom door, the bottom windows. So that little gap is for the notch that holds the central console. Okay, and then you cut your templates for these ones, and you see they fit perfectly. Okay, I'd recommend using the UV glue, like I showed before. I use this UV glue. Okay, Bondic. Okay, so what you do is you put a dab on one or two sections, put a piece of plastic over. Okay, this is not plastic, obviously. Then you can actually bond it with a UV light right through the plastic, and it stays in place. Okay, and with this, I've also upgraded the top or the roof section, or not the whole section, rather the edges, to make it more flush. It wasn't flush enough in my opinion. The new mold has one flaw, and that is it has a slight ridge along the edge. Okay, so fit them together and then sand it so they actually flush, or just sand it down and then just play around once you put the top on. Okay, this is not clear, but it's so you can see easier what I'm talking about. You can see this light groove along the edge because I extended the section. Okay, this side you might see it easier. Okay, so just sand it down smooth. Important thing again with the doors is to remove them. Don't twist or pull or anything. Stick a small ruler into the gap and then just twist it. Okay, till it pops out. There, and then just slide this down the center. It comes out. Okay, never pull it like a door, or try and maneuver it like a real door, because it's gonna snap the pin off, and then you'll have to glue it in place permanently, or get a replacement from me. Okay, so now that's it for that one. Next, I'll go over some lighting upgrades. Okay, till the next one. Cheers.